Since the beginning of civilization, human beings have sought to understand both the divine and physical worlds. And over time, two branches of knowledge have evolved to address similar questions, namely spirituality and science. But as science delves further into the unknown, we find that scientific research is merging with ancient spiritual insights about God, the Creator and Absolute, as revealed in many of the world's scriptures. In recent years, as the spiritual elevation of the Earth has been increasing, scientists have spent more time researching the aspects of science which are closely aligned with the divine. As a result, scientists have made some amazing discoveries, such as one particle existing simultaneously in two places, the third eye, the aura, the power of prayer, and the zero-point field. It seems we have reached the golden age, where science and spirituality walk together hand in hand.
Welcome, radiant viewers, to Science and Spirituality. Did you know that even when you think you are in darkness, you are actually swimming in an ocean of light? On today's episode, we take a scientific venture into that subatomic world of light as we visit the International Institute of Biophysics in Neuss, Germany. Through our visit, we will gain a better understanding of the branch of science called biophotonics and show you some of its exciting potential applications in the field of health and well-being. For this series, Supreme Master Television had a wonderful and unique opportunity to visit with Professor Fritz Albert Popp, founder of the International Institute of Biophysics. He has spent the last 30 years researching how the cells of the body communicate via light photons. Professor Popp has said, "We know today that man is essentially a being of light." We begin by joining Professor Popp in the laboratory for a concrete demonstration.
Welcome to Supreme Master Television, and thank you very much for having us over in your institute.
You are welcome.
Inside is very dark when I close the door, and the plant has brought the light from outside. And if I put on the device, then you can see the light which is now emitted from the plant on the screen.
Nothing connected to the plant.
Nothing connected to the plant. It's just the plant itself. The light, what the plant has stored from outside, and it's now emitting the light. And you see, the intensity is now decreasing. It's going down. And intensity. Here you see the plant is not here, and you also see the flickering of the photons. That's from the background. With other devices we have a better background solution. And now you don't see much more here. And we have the possibility to illuminate the plant again. I will do that now. Now we are illuminating it. And if I now switch on, the plant has also stored the light.
But it doesn't have anything to do with chlorophyll, right?
No, it doesn't have to do with that. That's the biophotons. Every biological and non-biological systems can store a bit of light.
If you waited long enough, there will be still light.
Yes, yes. So the light is always there.
And you can detect it.
We can detect it. We have some photomultipliers that are much more sensitive than this camera, because this plant is emitting much of light.
When we return, Professor Popp will tell us more about biophotons and the role that these light particles play at the cellular level.
We'll be right back after a brief message.
beginning of civilization, humans have sought to understand both the divine.
It seems we have reached the golden age, where science and spirituality work together hand in hand.
Welcome back to Science and Spirituality.
This is Science and Spirituality on Supreme Master Television, bringing you our show on biophotonics. Professor Pop, founder of the International Institute of Biophysics, explains to us what a biophoton is and its crucial role in cellular communication.
Maybe we should explain a little bit what photon is, because it's an elementary particle of light, right?
Yeah.
So when you say that there are only a few photons, it's a very, very low intensity of light.
Very low intensity. It corresponds to a candle at a distance of about 20 kilometers. So they are really single units of an electromagnetic field. Photons are events, are processes where energy is taken up by the multiplier or by a detector from an external electromagnetic field.
Can you please share with us what they actually are, how do they work, and where are they coming from?
The biophotons are photons coming out from living systems. Therefore, we say not bioluminescence, but we say biophotons, because they are so weak that you can count single photons. And the best is to tell you at an example what they do and why they are important. We have in every cell, we have about 100,000 chemical reactions per second. If I say 21, 22, in every of your cells there happened 100,000 chemical reactions. And nobody can tell you who is responsible for that chemical reaction takes place just at the right time and on the right position. And if I tell you there are photons which are responsible for that, because a chemical reaction can only happen if the molecule which is reacting is excited by a photon. So the photon is necessary to stimulate a molecule to a chemical reactions.
So any alive tissue, any alive cells produce photons, produces light.
We are swimming in an ocean of light. It is very impossible to get a complete darkness. You have always photons. Some people say it's not surprising that in the cells you have also photons. But it is surprising because of the following. Not the intensity of the photons are important, but they have a very high degree of coherence.
When we return with our interview with Professor Popp of the International Institute of Biophysics in Germany, we'll explore more on the fascinating topic of biophotons.
We'll be right back after this brief message.
Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out in the summer's day with eyes that watch the world and can forget, like the strangers that you met, the ragged man in ragged clothes, silver thorns and the bloody rose, lie crushed and broken under virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, how you suffer for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they still listen now. Starry, starry night, hang your clouds blue and gray. Look out in the summer's day with eyes that watch the world and can forget. Like the strangers that you met, the ragged man in the ragged clothes, silver thorns and the bloody rose, lie crushed and broken under virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, how you suffer for your sanity, how you try to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they still listen now.